E. Wood Coliseum back on December the 11th, 2022. And certainly the most impressive win of the year for the Choctaws, a 30-point victory over the Chargers, 92-62. And really, it's been the defense that has stepped up in a big way for the Chargers in this three-game win streak, giving up 54, 55, and 50, respectively. And the last time we took on the Choctaws, it was Tre'Davious Thompson going for 47 in that game. Now, he does lead the Choctaws in points per game at 18 points per game. He has scored 379 points this year, but it feels like half of those came against us back in December. We'll take a timeout, and my conversation with head coach John Shulman comes up after this word from Valley Equipment Rental.
What's better than Valley Equipment Rental? Two Valley Equipment Rentals, and that's just what we have now. The original on the South Memorial Parkway between Drake and Airport Road, and their second location on North Memorial Parkway, just north of Winchester Road. Valley Equipment is locally owned and has more skid steers, excavators, and lifts than anyone in the area, plus all the small tools that you need to get the job done like a pro. And if you are a pro, you need to check out the new north location now, because Valley Equipment has what you need. Learn more at valleyequipmentrents.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Glad to be back at home. Coach, if we can relive Groundhog Day, that was a nice one to relive on Thursday.
Had a good night. Came out with good energy. Did a nice job on Dietrich. Dietrich was coming in making eight threes a game on us. Like I said, it's hard to guard inside and out. And but we did a good job. I thought we did a pretty good job on Cartwright. You know, if he doesn't shoot it, he's not going to score. And we did a decent job on our doubles. But we did a good job on their perimeter. Good job defensively. Average job on the glass. We didn't get enough offensive glass, offensive rebounds, I know, for the game. But we shot it good. And we, you know, playing against a matchup zone is not always easy. But listen, I'm not going to complain. We, you know, the nice thing is we won by 27. The nice thing is they only scored 50 points. 54 points to Shorter, 55 to Lee, 50 to Delta State, and 47 to Jadarius Thompson, or what his name coming in. We almost gave as many points to one player at Mississippi College as we did the last three outings. So don't think that we haven't spoken about that. We hadn't talked about it. But if you hold a team to 50 points, you got a chance to win a lot of basketball games.
Rebounding in particular, how much is it bounce of the ball? How much is it effort?
Probably a little bit of both. You know, I mean, but our effort revolves around boxing out. And a lot of people don't box out. A lot of people don't put emphasis on boxing out. A lot of people recruit rebounding. You know, they don't have to worry about it. Just go rebound a ball. And we don't recruit rebounding, but it's very important to me. It's always been very important to me. It's very important in my career as a basketball coach. In 05, when we went to the NCAA tournament and should have beaten Wake Forest, we were number two in the country in rebound margin at like 10.8. We're really good at rebounding. This team can be decent at rebounding if we'll just completely focus on continuing to box out. What an unbelievable test today, because we're playing against a really good rebounding team. We got dominated on the glass at MC. Let's see if, you know, in the first 5 minutes, let's see if we can, you know, punch somebody in the face and punk somebody early, or we got punked down there at their place, and credit goes to them. They're tough, they're mean, they're nasty, they're athletic, they're well coached, and they're really good on the defensive end and really good on the glass.
It kind of... We don't really focus too much here lately about CJ not playing, but this is a kid who was that I don't have to tell you, Coach, the tournament player of the GSC last year. But really, I wanted to focus on Dane Harding and what he has done to not necessarily fill his shoes, but certainly fill his starting role.
Well, Dane's athleticism, he's walking by right now. That's why I said that. Dane Harding. I will say this, and early in practice this year, we're in the middle of practice, and I went, I hate to tell y'all this, but like Dane's one of our best players. He's one of our best players. And I don't know where we put him on the floor or figure this thing out, but Dane's one of our better players. And, you know, he was playing a three. CJ gets hurt against Auburn. We throw Dane in there, easy weekend against the number two team in America, and at that time number six team in America, whatever. And all he does is flourish. All he does is help us win. And as a starter, I think Dane is 10-1 as a starter this year. His only loss is to Nova Southeastern, and I don't think that's a crying shame. He makes shots. He thinks. He's a coach's son. He's tough. This is a kid that's had three shoulder surgeries and really can't lift his arms above his shoulders. And so what he's done is spectacular. He is special. He's a special kid. He doesn't say boo, but he's a competitive kid. He's going to have his hands full today. Galen Smith is probably the best big in our league, but it's just not up to Dane to stop him. It's up to our team to stop him. But what Dane and Thurman do is Dane and Thurman go back to what Princeton offense was started for. You put a five-man out there who can pass, catch, think, and shoot, and you're literally unguardable, just to be honest. You put Saylor in there, he's got to play it a different way. You put CJ in there, he's got to play it a different way. And so with CJ in there and with Saylor in there and with Dane and Thurman in there, you have three different offenses, but you're running the same offense. But, Dane's got to be a pick-and-pop guy, and if he can make threes, we're really hard to guard.
The growth of Thurman. I'll just leave it at that, Coach.
Well, listen, Thurman, we went up there and watched him. He came to elite camp. We went up there and watched him, and my wife threatened to divorce me if we didn't sign Matt Thurman. She was like, you go get him now. Matt Thurman fits us. His personality fits us. He won a boatload of basketball games at Franklin High School. He can shoot it. He can pass it. He can think. He is a wonderful kid. So him making three threes in a row at the end of that game doesn't shock me. He, for a freshman, he doesn't have a conscience. He's like, just give me the ball and let me shoot it. But he can really pass it. And when given time and when given the opportunity, like Matt Thurman is going to be a really special player here at UAH. He fits our culture. He fits everything that we do here. And it's a lot of fun to watch him grow.
Qualis Corporation, headquartered here in Huntsville, is a woman-owned small business providing technical services in the areas of engineering analysis, testing, and support services to both commercial and government customers. For 29 years, Qualis employees have provided award-winning support to complex technical and engineering efforts, helping ensure critical programs, products, and systems are acquired, tested, and fully operational when fielded. Qualis Corporation, proud sponsor of the UAH Chargers. Go Chargers!
Tom Luganbill here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience the tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there, Woody Anderson Ford.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Back inside Spraggans on a Saturday, getting ready for the Choctaws and Chargers to square off, along with Scott Tyson, Steve Moulton back here with you. And the last time we saw these Choctaws, well, I'm still seeing Thompson score left and right and ended up with 47 on us.
Yeah, and Steve, if you think this Charger team has forgotten what happened to them in Clinton, Mississippi, you are wrong. Last year, the redemption tour was the thing. We could have made T-shirts and sold them by the dozens,
yeah,
and just had redemption on them. Coach alluded to that in the locker room just a little bit ago. he looked at Hunter Vick and he said, Hunter, this is why we beat you guys last year, was because of a redemption tour. That was our motto last year. And he goes, guys, I don't even remember what happened on Thursday. Because this whole week has not been about the Delta State game. It was not about leading into that one. It was about today. And he goes, I want us to go out here today and remember what happened there in Clinton, Mississippi. This is a matchup problem for UAH. The Choctaws are a matchup problem. They are bigger, they are stronger, and they are just a little bit more aggressive on the glass than what UAH is. UAH has got to box out. They've got to be aggressive. Offensively, if UAH is patient today, they'll be able to get back cuts. They'll be able to get to the rim. They've got to be patient. They've got to move, and they just cannot afford to lapse defensively. They've got to come out. They've got to close on the defenders. Coach told them, you guys know the Gulf South Conference tournament. You've been there. You know what it's about. Mississippi College has never been to the Gulf South Conference tournament.
That's right.
They don't know the pressure of playing like UAH. Coach says, use that to your advantage.
One guy in particular, I didn't talk about it with Coach, but defensively, Daniel Saylor has grown a ton and has really turned into a force in the paint, blocking shots and just getting in the way. And I'm excited to see what he does here today.
Well, Daniel Saylor has the frame. He's always had the frame. He's just that big 6'11 guy. He's just had to learn how to play with that frame. And for a big guy, sometimes that takes a little bit. Takes some adjustment coming from high school where you can easily dominate a game, and coming into college for guys smaller than you, but they're still bigger and tougher than you. It takes a little bit to get used to. And for Daniel Saylor, it's all starting to slow down for him.
It is time to introduce the starting lineups, and it's brought to you by the law firm of Martinson and Beeson. Their lineup of attorneys are top-ranked Alabama personal injury attorneys ready to help you. That is Martinson and Beeson. First up for the visitors from Clinton, Mississippi, under head coach Randy Bolden, they will go with number one, Miles Miller, a junior from Meridian, Mississippi, and a transfer from Ole Miss and Lipscomb. Number three, Tre'Davious Thompson, a junior from Raymond.
I just came back for the win. Lot of new money in my hand. Go on, tell a friend to tell a friend. They say success is the best revenge. Heard they were sleeping again, say it no more. This is a rude awakening, kicking the door. Back and I'm better than ever before. Don't get it mistaken, I'm ready for war. I see the ice and I'm up in the score. I catch a body, then jump in the course. Follow the core and I'm back to the morgue. Take the sheet off and I kill him some more. When I am done at the scene, I won't leave anything. You won't even know who was involved. Don't let me do it, cause I overdo it and do it till I cannot do it no more. All of the doubters, I'm proving them wrong. Back with the classic, I know it's been long. Heard they was missing me while I was gone. I smell the victory back up on top, and it's where I belong. Like it ain't to me, we making history. Fall through the misery, weather the storm. Can't let them get to me, no weapon form shall prosper. Be still over my roster. I got options, I keep a chopper right on the dresser. Next to the Oscar, applying pressure. Somebody stop us.
72 of them. 11, number 11, Jack Costell, the sophomore from Mill Creek High School in Decatur, Georgia. Number 23, Dane Harding, the sophomore from Albertville, Alabama. Number 31, Cheney Johnson, fresh off of getting his key into the 1,000-point club in the last game against Delta State. And number 33, Max Schulman, who is now the all-time leader in 3 points made in a Charger uniform, with over 300 of them made in a Charger uniform, as he passed Jamie Smith with that title 2 games ago. Choctaws will be in the road yellow jerseys with blue letters and numbers. Chargers in the home white uniforms with the numbers in blue, UAH in white etched in blue. 20 minutes is up on the clock. This should be a good one. Glad to have you along on Zone 2. If you want to see the video associated with this audio, head over to YouTube for the free video. First possession belongs to the Choctaws. Miller brings it up. We're switching man-to-man. Thompson sends it into the corner. Williams needs help and lobs it underneath and gets it right back to him. 10 on the shot clock as it's tipped and stolen away. Chargers will run it up. Love the intensity there out of the gate defensively.
Yeah, it's a good first defensive possession for UAH. Very aggressive.
Chaney along the baseline kicks it outside to Dane Harding. Harding looks back door, but it's tipped. Ends up in Max Schulman's hands with 10 on the shot clock. Jack bounces it to Max. Harding with 7 on the shot clock. Max will drive it. Max at the buzzer, floats it and misses it. Rebounded by the Choctaws. Good defense, frankly, on both ends.
Yeah, that's a good Mississippi College is strong, Steve. They closed off that lane pretty good.
Thompson misses that floater. Ball tipped up into the air, and Chaney ends up with it. Luke Burnett on the other end lays it up and in. That's a steal. It turns into a score. 2-0. Chargers with the early advantage. Boy, if we play defense like this the entire game, we may have like a 10-9 game. Bounce pass down underneath. Kick it on the wing to Thompson. Down along the baseline to Reed. Fires it into the corner. That floater's no good. Rebounded by Chaney. Again, solid defense here for the Chargers.
Good job by Chaney Johnson, Steve. He stayed straight up, closed off the lane, though. Wouldn't let him drive baseline. Affected that shot.
Chaney underneath, lays it up and in. Nice feed from Max Schulman underneath. It's a 4-0 lead for the Chargers. 2 minutes gone here into this opening half. Choctaws with it. That's Thompson. Thompson drives it in to the free throw line, kicks it outside to Miller. Miller fires it down low and swatted away by Chaney Johnson. But Galen Smith will head to the free throw line after that foul by Chaney. Smith to the free throw line. Smith is an 80% free throw shooter on the year. Front end is good. First point for the Choctaws. Come at the free throw line.
Well, Steve, if Galen Smith is in the game and we do get to see, and we will see Daniel Saylor.
Yes.
That could be an interesting chess match down low there of big men.
That's kind of why I went there in the pregame. They match up pretty well physically. Chaney, elbow jumper, no good. Hard off the base of the iron. Stick back, no good, but Max Schulman was bumped by Justin Reed. And Max will head to the free throw line for 2 as well. Right now the lead is 2 at 4-2.
Shooter number 33, Max Schulman. And Schulman for 2.
That rolls in for Max. He'll get one more. Second free throw is good as well. 6-2 start for the Chargers. 2.5 minutes gone here into this opening half. Miller finds Smith, big man out beyond the arc. Handed over to Thompson. Open three on the wing. No good for Miller. Tapped around. It ping-pongs around, and Max Schulman fires it forward. Watch out of that elbow there, Max. Handed over to Luke Burnett for 3. It is good! That is the 73rd made 3 of the year, and a 9-2 start for the Chargers, and a 30-second timeout has been called by Mississippi College.
What's better than Valley Equipment Rental? 2 Valley Equipment Rentals, and that's just what we have now. The original on the South Memorial Parkway between Drake and Airport Road, and their second location on North Memorial Parkway, just north of Winchester Road. Valley Equipment is locally owned and has more skid steers, excavators, and lifts than anyone in the area, plus all the small tools that you need to get the job done like a pro. And if you are a pro, you need to check out the new North location now, because Valley Equipment has what you need. Learn more at valleyequipmentrents.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Choctaws to plug it in. I do not see substitution. Actually, McCrary has checked in for the Choctaws.
Well, Coach Shulman just basically praising the rebounding effort, telling them they got to stay rebounding and stay tough on the defensive side of the ball.
Miller drives it hard baseline, kicks it outside Thompson for three. No good. Smith loses the handle, stolen away. Here's a 2-on-2. Now the Chargers wait for everybody to climb aboard. Harding, top of the key, sends it over to Max for three. Rattles home! Max Shulman now has 5 of our 12, and the lead is 10 at 12-2.
Well, defensively, this is where it started from the get-go. UH has been phenomenal early defensively.
Reed sends it down low. Smith gets double-teamed, sends it back outside to Miller. Bounce pass over to McCrary, and he loses the handle, but it's last touched by Cheney, so it'll stay MC possession with 9 on the shot clock.
Well, the one thing UAH is doing is they're putting themselves in the passing lanes. They're being aggressive with that ball. They're just getting a hand on the ball, disrupting the Choctaws' offensive flow.
Choctaws have yet to make a field goal in this game. They're 0-for-4. Their only points have come at the free throw line. A long three is no good at the buzzer. Galen Smith, stick back is good. Well, yeah, so that is the first field goal off the offensive glass.
Well, Cheney got caught outside the lane, Steve. And, I mean, Max Shulman is strong, but he's not going to be able to get that defensive rebound.
Luke Burnett looking for Cheney. Rolls it down to him along the baseline. The sophomore attacks the paint. Spins, floats it. And one for Cheney Johnson. Boy, Cheney has really grown. And that was pretty. 14-4, a 10-point lead for the Chargers. Timeout on the floor with 15:44 to go in the first half. Now this from Brian Bellamy.
Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance, located in the Rosie's Shopping Plaza, strives to help customers find the best auto insurance, home insurance, life insurance, and more. No matter where you are in life, Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance is here to help you find your best insurance and retirement needs. You can find them on the web at brianbellamyagency.com or call them at 256-539-7530. Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance is a proud supporter of UAH Athletics and reminds everyone to go Chargers. Brian Bellamy State Farm, here to help life go right.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I have personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by other
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Along with Scott Tyson, Steve Moulton back here with you. Saturday in Spragans continues as the Chargers lead it 14-4 over the Choctaws as Cheney Johnson will head to the free throw line for his and one.
Well, Coach Shulman just reminding everyone in that timeout, Steve, that they've got to crash the glass. It's not one person's responsibility. It's everybody's. And they're going to stay with the same defensive set with this group on the floor. Usually they've changed it up with the second five. They asked this group if they have the if they have it to do it.
Free throw's no good, and MC brings it up. 12 on the shot clock. Miller drives it in, kicks it outside to Thompson. Thompson back to Miller. 7 on the shot clock. Miller gets a high pick from Smith. Miller lobs it underneath to Smith, and he'll lay it up and in. Nice little give and go, if you will, there for MC.
Yeah, and see, that was a mismatch. Daniel Saylor caught behind the arc, and Smith with Tanner Shulman. That's a mismatch in favor of Mississippi College.
Three ball on the other end is no good for Cheney Johnson, and here come the Choctaws. Running it up, McCrary sends it over on the wing to Thompson. Miller rolls it underneath to Smith. He'll send it back outside. Miller hesitates, back down low to Smith, and it's blocked away by Cheney. Ends up on the deck. Why did the shot clock reset, and the three in the corner is good. Gross comes away with the made field goal, and it's a 5-point Charger lead. The lead was 10. Max, a long three, is no good. Here come the Choctaws. running it up, walking with it. No call. Kick it out for a three is no good. That time by Gross. Hunter Vick brings it up for the Chargers. Gets a high pick, doesn't use it, drives it into some traffic, kick it into the corner to Cheney. He'll attack it. Euro step floater, good. That has worked very well for Cheney the past 2 weeks.
Well, that was a strong effort, Steve. Not trying to settle going away from the basket. Cheney Johnson is good when he faces the basket.
Miller hands it over. That's to McCrary. Drives it in, muscles his way up. Swatted away by Daniel Saylor. Here comes Hunter Vick. Hunter Vick brings it up. Finds Tanner Shulman over to his brother Max. Max swings it in the corner to Vick. Vick dribbles it out and finds Saylor at the free throw line. Underneath the Cheney, you get shoved. No call. Cheney into the paint. Freedom of movement, my foot. As that ball is blocked away cleanly at the last second by Miller. Yeah, freedom of movement. Into the corner, open three, no good. Galen Smith with the stick back, no good as well. Nice recovery defensively that time by Cheney Johnson.
Well, Steve, Galen Smith is winded.
Yeah.
He is, this pace has been too much for him. UAH needs to take advantage of it. Get it down low, work him out.
Cheney Johnson to Tanner Shulman, back to Cheney. Cheney attacks it, into the paint, floats it. Scores it. Cheney Johnson is absolutely feeling it within 5 feet right now. 18-9. Chargers lead it with 12:38 to go in the half. Miller gets a high pick. Swings it. They're looking down low. They find Smith. Kick it outside. Stolen away. Here comes Max Shulman. Max Shulman hesitates. Underneath the Saylor. And Saylor's fouled. No call. Misses the dunk. And here come the Choctaws. Miller sends it into the far corner. Smith will float it and score it. You're right. Boy, he is...
He is the last player up and down the floor. This pace is it favoring UAH, and then the defensive intensity is favoring UAH. Now they just got to take advantage of it.
Saylor bounces it out twice and finds Max Shulman. Max drives it hard along the baseline. Shulman in a double team kicks it out to Cheney Johnson. Saylor with five on the shot clock finds Tanner at the buzzer. Banked it in! He banked it in! Tanner Shulman dialing it up deep gives the Chargers a 10-point lead.
Just tee it up high and let it fly, I guess.
8.5 minutes gone here into this first half, 21-11. Chargers with the lead. Miller sends it up top of the key to McCrary. Three ball, Thompson, good. Remember him? Thompson, who scored 47 on us in Mississippi, gets his first bucket here in Huntsville. Saylor dribbles it out, looks back door, finds Max, who lays it up and in. Max Shulman now has 7 of our 23.
We mentioned, Steve, that backdoor cut is going to be there all game. If the Chargers are patient and run the offense, they will have that look.
Lead is 9 right now. Miller holds it. Down low, it goes to Smith, and he'll block it away by Daniel Saylor. And a foul underneath on Saylor. But it looked like Galen Smith was about to dunk it home, and Daniel said, 10:36 to go in the half. UAH 23. Mississippi College 14.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. 4 locations and on the web at SportsMed. Alabama.com.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Chargers shooting 53% from the floor, or 7 of 13. Mississippi College is 3 of 12 from the floor. They are shooting 25% from the floor. Chargers lead it right now by 9. It feels like it should be bigger.
Yeah, and Steve, you look at the stat sheet, and right now it's not come back to hurt them yet, but Mississippi College has 5 offensive rebounds. UAH a minus 5 right now on the glass. So far it hasn't hurt UAH, but that is a number where UAH has got to improve as this game goes on. And Coach Shulman reminding them in that timeout that this is a 40-minute game. And yeah, they've got to play for that full 40.
When Galen Smith makes the front end of his free throws, he's now 3 for 3 at the free throw line. Second free throw is up and no good. 23-15, Chargers with the lead in the basketball. 10.5 minutes left to go before halftime. Dane Harding for 3. It is good! Dane Harding pick up where he left off against Delta State. Lead grows to 11, tying our largest lead of the game. Miller swings it. McCrary sends it over on the near side to Miller. Smith gets double teamed. Move it around the arc to Thompson for 3, and it's good. You know who? Thompson's second made bucket. He came in averaging 18 points a game.
Well, Coach Shulman, Steve, after that 3, went up and down the bench and just said he had 47 on us. Remember?
Oh, yeah.
So, I mean, every shot.
Luke Burnett has it on the wing, finds Dane Harding. Luke, a long 3, is no good off the front of the rim. Miller will slow the tempo down. Chargers lead it 26-18. Miller dribbles it out at midcourt. Miller gets a high double pick this time. Lob it underneath to Smith, and he is fouled on his way up. He was being defended by Jack Costell, and that's not what you want.
Well, you look at the 5 on the floor for UAH right now, Steve. I mean, Chaney getting a break, Daniel Saylor getting a break right now. And Galen Smith is going to be a handful down low in the paint for the Chargers. And who's going to step up in that 5 when we need that break right now? I mean, Dalton Dodd is going to have to step into that role and try to control Galen Smith in that paint.
Galen Smith now has 10 of their 19 points. Second free throw is up and good. Galen Smith is a problem right now as he now has 11 of their 20 points. Chargers lead it by 6, 26-20. Feels like the lead should be bigger, but it's not. Costell on the wing. 3 dribbles, rolls it underneath to Dalton Dodd. Dodd back to the bucket, backs his way into the paint. Dodd muscles his way up, floats it off the glass. No good. Boy, he was right there. Miller will slowly walk it up. And here comes the tempo that we saw in Clinton. Down along the baseline, McCrary sends it in the corner. Open 3. Good. This feels, unfortunately, very familiar.
Well, Steve, the defensive effort, I mean, early on was fantastic. Mississippi College didn't even get a look from a 3. Now they've had back-to-back open looks.
Dane Harding will drive it in. Skip it outside. Down underneath it goes to Max Shulman. Dane Harding for 3. It is good for Dane. He's made 2 threes, and the lead grows back up to 6. But the tempo definitely feels like it's flipped a little bit towards Mississippi College.
It has, and Mississippi College would love to, and right now they're able to get this game into a half-court game.
Yes.
UAH wants a little bit of tempo.
That ball is tipped out of bounds defensively by Dane Harding, and a timeout on the floor. Chargers lead it, but Mississippi College definitely in the neighborhood. 29-23. Chargers with the lead. Now this from SportsMed.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care. Specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Four locations and on the web at sportsmedalabama.com.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Chargers shooting 58% from the floor, and we're only leading it by six. Rebounding totals. Mississippi College is out-rebounding us by six. And the offensive glass as well. They're at a plus four, 5-1 in that regard as well.
Well, Coach Holman telling them, hey, you know, look, offensively we're fine. Defensively, if you don't get back into position or you don't find your spots, we're going to get clipped.
Free throw line jumper is good for Thompson. That is his third made field goal. The lead is cut to four. 29-25. Luke Burnett is left open. He'll fire it and miss it. Rebounded by Miller.
Well, the starting five is back on the floor now. So let's see if we can pick up that defensive intensity. And
yeah.
And this has been Mississippi College's ball. We knew it was going to be like a chess match.
Lob it underneath, and there was an ill-fated alley-oop right there. Chargers bring it up. Luke Burnett moves it over to Max Schulman. Harding on the elbow. Dane, one dribble, hands it over to Max Schulman. Max is fouled by Miller. That's his second. Team's third. Saylor is in for Harding. It's Max Schulman, Luke Burnett, Dane just checked out. Daniel Saylor, Cheney Johnson, and Jack Costell. Inbounds it goes to Cheney. Pump fake, lays it up and in. That was almost too easy for Cheney.
Well, it was, and he should have also been rewarded with a free
and
throw
one. Yeah.
As well, but not called. But made baskets are what's going to help UAH kind of speed this game up a little bit where they can put a little pressure on the Choctaws.
Chargers in a zone defense. In the near corner it goes, down underneath, and a foul. Daniel Saylor with a bump. That is his second foul.
Well, and I think Coach Schulman wanted Daniel Saylor not to be behind him. He wants him to front, I think. I think he wants him to front Galen Smith.
Choctaws to plug it in with 20 on the shot clock. Inbounds it goes. Thompson has it on the wing. Thompson drives it, kicks it up top of the key. Swing it over to Williams. 10 on the shot clock. Smith to Thompson for three. No good. Rebound is by the Choctaws, and a foul will send Justin Reed to the free throw line.
Well, Steve, that's going to be three on Daniel Saylor.
Is that? I thought it was on Max Schulman.
No, that's his third.
Wow.
So Daniel Saylor will have to go to the bench for the rest of the first half.
Thurman is at the scorer's table. Justin Reed to the free throw line. Looks for his first point and gets it. Reed, a sophomore from Miami, Florida.
And the Choctaws, Trey Bates, number 13.
Second free throw, eventually, is good. 31-27. Chargers maintain the lead, but it's a little too close for comfort. Thurman in on the elbow. Kicks it outside to Luke Burnett. He'll swing it to Max. Lose the handle, stolen away by Miller. And Miller, again, will slow the tempo down as Coach Bolden immediately throws up both hands and says, slow down. Miller swings it into the near corner. Open three, no good. That went off of Galen Smith's face and out of bounds. And I think it went off of his nose. He's starting to grab it. Chargers run it up, leading it 31-27. Chaney swings it to Jack Costell. Find Chaney. We found him along the baseline. He'll attack the baseline into the paint, pivots, powers his way up, and he's fouled on his way up by Reed. There was about three fouls right there, honestly.
Well, that's twice we've seen UAH get that ball to Chaney Johnson along the baseline, and they clear it out. And Chaney had the mismatch there, and when he goes to work, he's able to spin. As long as he spins towards the basket, when Chaney gets the ball along the baseline, sometimes he has a tendency to take that step and push backwards away from the basket. UAH wants them to go towards the basket where things like this happen, where he gets to the free throw line.
Both free throws are good for Chaney. He came in averaging 15.6 in this one. He already has 12 in the first half. Lead grows to 6 at 33-27. That's Miller dribbling it out at midcourt for the Choctaws. Miller lobs it underneath to Smith, powers his way up, and lays it up and in. Galen Smith now has 13 of the Choctaws' 29. Max Schulman drives it into the elbow. Kick it out to Thurman for three. No good. Thurman was drilled down by Galen Smith. No call there. Under 5 minutes left to go before halftime. Miller dribbles it out. Miller sends it in the corner. Step back three, no good. Rebounded by Jack Costell. Chargers bring it up, leading it 33-29. Jack trying to lay it up, blocked away. Choctaws run it back. Miller out on the wing. Sends it in the corner to Thompson. They play a game of catch. They're looking for Smith. They find him, and he gets double teamed. Kicks it outside to Thompson. 10 on the shot clock. Miller holds it, swings it to Thompson. A long two is an air ball taken out by Chaney. That was a nice defensive possession.
It was, and a great job by Matt Thurman, Steve, on Galen Smith, preventing that ball from really getting into the lane.
Thurman holds it. He is open, but lobs it underneath to Chaney. Layup is no good. Boy, Chaney got an elbow to his upper torso. I mean, it was shoved. Choctaws dribble it out. Miller stops his dribble, lobs it underneath. It went through the wicket that time. A little too tall on that pass. Turns into turnover number 5 for Mississippi College. Thurman, a long three. No good, hard off the iron. We have taken 12 three attempts in this one out of our 26 shots. 3 minutes to go. It's a 33-29 lead for the Chargers. Thompson, a long two. Good. Fourth made field goal for Tre'Davious Thompson. The lead is 2 and 33-31. It feels like Mississippi College withstood our initial punch and then some.
Well, they have, and they've gotten the game into their tempo, and they've gotten it the way they want to play, Steve, which is getting that ball inside and then kicking it back out to their open shooters.
Costell, 7 on the shot clock, drives it along the baseline, turns, shoots, and a floater, and it's no good. Tipped out, ends up in Jack's hands. Finds Chaney for three. It is good! Wow, what a tough make that time by Chaney. That was a fadeaway into the visiting bench.
Well, and Max Schulman kind of crowding that line there. We had two Chargers in the same place.
Under 2 minutes left to go before halftime. The lead is five. Thompson attacks the baseline. A long two is no good. Rebounded by Mississippi College. That's her seventh offensive board. Three on the wing, no good. That's an over-the-back not called. Ends up on the deck, and Luke Burnett comes back out with it.
Yeah, I don't know what the ref saw there. I mean, it happened 2 feet from him.
Luke drives it, lays it up, no good. Rebounded by Chaney. Chaney spins it, lays it up and in, and one for Chaney Johnson. The sophomore from Thompson High School will get the end one after our final media timeout. Minute and 30 seconds to go in this first half. Chargers leading at 38. To 31.
Qualis Corporation, headquartered here in Huntsville, is a woman-owned small business providing technical services in the areas of engineering analysis, testing, and support services to both commercial and government customers. For 29 years, Qualis employees have provided award-winning support to complex technical and engineering efforts, helping ensure critical programs, products, and systems are acquired, tested, and fully operational when fielded. Qualis Corporation, proud sponsor of the UAH Chargers. Go Chargers.
Tom Luganbill here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience the tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there. Woody Anderson Ford.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
38-31 the score. Chargers leading it by seven. We've led it in this one by as much as 11 in this one. Back when it was 26-15. But Mississippi College has definitely bounced back after what was a 9-2 start out of the gate for UAH.
Well, Coach Shulman in that timeout, Steve, imploring, and I mean just trying to do anything he can to get these guys. He wants them to be more physical down low in the paint. He wants them to really be physical with Galen Smith, pleading for anybody on the court just to get physical down there, because they're getting a sense that if they can get physical, he's prone to turn the ball over.
Free throw is good. The lead grows to eight. Miller brings it up. Thompson swings it around the arc. They're looking for Smith down low, and it is on the deck, and what are they calling? A jump ball. Possession arrow to UAH. Nice job to jump the route defensively by Dalton Dodd. Incidentally, the five on the floor for the Chargers, Dane Harding, Max Shulman, Tanner Shulman, Dalton Dodd, and Hunter Vick on the floor for UAH. Galen Smith has played every second of this first half. Chance to get this thing back into double figures on this possession. The lead is eight. Max Shulman bounces it to Dane Harding at the elbow. Backdoor pass is there to Max, who lays it up and in. I got to believe that's there all day long.
Well, the coaches told the guys in the locker room pregame. I mean, that's something that they've noticed on film. It's something that they said, if you're patient and we run the right offense with tempo, you're going to be able to get that look all day.
Choctaws with the possession. That's Williams. Ends up in McCrary's hands with 10 on the shot clock. Nobody moving for the Choctaws. Driving it in. Little floater partially blocked, but there's Galen Smith. He'll miss the lay-in. Rebounded again by the Choctaws. Thompson out at midcourt with 15 on the shot clock. Thompson gets a high pick from Smith. He'll swing it to McCrary. Drives it in. Walked with it. He slid that pivot foot. Thompson sends it in the corner for an open three. No good. Rebounded by Galen Smith. Swatted away by Dalton Dodd. But it's out of bounds to Mississippi College.
Well, Vic doing everything he can to try to keep that ball in play, Steve. Ended up in the first row of the stands trying to keep that ball in play. But
6.1 to go, and Daniel Saylor is in. He has three fouls. Lob it underneath. The floater is no good. Galen Smith ends up on the deck, and the full court heave is no good. Wouldn't have counted anyway. A 10-point advantage for the Chargers here at halftime, 41-31. I mean, at times it felt like maybe this should have been a larger lead, but honestly, after what Mississippi College was able to accomplish, I'll take a 10-point lead heading into halftime.
Yeah, and interesting to see what Coach Shulman has to say. Obviously, it's been a physical ball game, that's for sure. All right, Coach, 41-31 at the break. You knew coming in it was going to be physical. They're getting that ball down to Galen Smith, really trying to make that paint a physical game.
Yeah, he's the best big in the league. He's the best big in the league. They're doing a great job of getting the ball in there to him. We're doing an average job of fighting in there. We got to fight more. We got to bust or tell him more. We got to get around some more. We got to do a better job on the glass. At least it gives me a lot of something to talk about at halftime. We got to do a better job on him. Get to Thompson shooting the ball, but we got to do a better job on Smith.
There we go. See, we've talked about it in the first half, just how big of a factor he was for this Charger squad, or for Mississippi College, and how much he is a concern for UAH.
Thank you very much, Scott Tyson. We are at halftime. Chargers lead it by 10. As always, our halftime is brought to you by SportsMed Orthopedic Surgery and Spine Center. They invite you to give them a call today at 256-881-5151 to experience the SportsMed difference. SportsMed Orthopedic Surgery and Spine Center, dedicated to providing care that improves lives. Chargers 41, Choctaws 31. Here's my full conversation with head coach John Shulman from earlier today. Glad to be back at home. Coach, if we can relive Groundhog Day, that was a nice one to relive on Thursday.
Had a good night. Had a good night. Came out with good energy. Did a nice job on Dietrich. Dietrich was coming in making 8 threes a game on us. Like I said, it's hard to guard inside and out. And well, we did a good job. I thought we did a pretty good job on Cartwright. You know, if he doesn't shoot it, he's not going to score. And we did a decent job on our doubles. But we did a good job on their perimeter. Good job defensively, average job on the glass. We didn't get enough offensive glass, offensive rebounds, I know, for the game. But we shot it good. And we, you know, playing against a matchup zone is not always easy. But listen, I'm not going to complain. We, you know, the nice thing is we won by 27. The nice thing is they only scored 50 points. 54 points to Shorter, 55 to Lee, 50 to Delta State, and 47 to Jadarius Thompson, or what his name coming in. We almost gave as many points to one player at Mississippi College as we did the last three outings. So don't think that we haven't spoken about that. We hadn't talked about it. But if you hold a team to 50 points, you got a chance to win a lot of basketball games.
Rebounding in particular, how much is it bounce of the ball? How much is it effort?
Probably a little bit of both. You know, I mean, but our effort revolves around boxing out. And a lot of people don't box out. A lot of people don't put emphasis on boxing out. A lot of people recruit rebounding. You know, they don't have to worry about it. Just go rebound a ball. And we don't recruit rebounding, but it's very important to me. It's always been very important to me. It's very important in my career as a basketball coach. In 2005, when we went to the NCAA tournament and should have beaten Wake Forest, we were number 2 in the country in rebound margin at like 10.8. We're really good at rebounding. This team can be decent at rebounding if we'll just completely focus on continuing to box out. What an unbelievable test today, because we're playing against a really good rebounding team. We got dominated on the glass at MC. Let's see if, you know, in the first 5 minutes, let's see if we can, you know, punt somebody in the face and punk somebody early, or we got punked down there at their place, and credit goes to them. They're tough, they're mean, they're nasty, they're athletic, they're well coached, and they're really good on the defensive end and really good on the glass.
It kind of we don't really focus too much here lately about CJ not playing, but this is a kid who was that I don't have to tell you, Coach, the tournament player of the GSC last year. But really, I wanted to focus on Dane Harding and what he has done to not necessarily fill his shoes, but certainly fill his starting role.
Well, Dane's athleticism, he's walking by right now. That's why I said that. Dane Harding, I will say this, and early in practice this year, we're in the middle of practice, and I went, I hate to tell y'all this, but like Dane's one of our best players. He's one of our best players. And I don't know where we put him on the floor or figure this thing out, but Dane's one of our better players. And, you know, he was playing a three. CJ gets hurt against Auburn. We throw Dane in there, easy weekend against the number two team in America, and at that time number six team in America, whatever. And all he does is flourish. All he does is help us win. And as a starter, I think Dane is 10-1 as a starter this year. His only loss is to Nova Southeastern, and I don't think that's a crying shame. He makes shots. He thinks. He's a coach's son. He's tough. This is a kid that's had three shoulder surgeries and really can't lift his arms above his shoulders. And so what he's done is spectacular. He is special. He's a special kid. He doesn't say boo, but he's a competitive kid. He's going to have his hands full today. Galen Smith is probably the best big in our league, but it's just not up to Dane to stop him. It's up to our team to stop him. But what Dane and Thurman do is Dane and Thurman go back to what Princeton offense was started for. You put a five-man out there who can pass, catch, think, and shoot, and you're literally unguardable, just to be honest. You put Saylor in there, he's got to play it a different way. You put CJ in there, he's got to play it a different way. And so with CJ in there and with Saylor in there and with Dane and Thurman in there, you have three different offenses, but you're running the same offense. But, Dane's got to be a pick-and-pop guy, and if he can make threes, we're really hard to guard.
The growth of Thurman. I'll just leave it at that, Coach.
Well, listen, Thurman, we went up there and watched him. He came to Elite Camp. We went up there and watched him, and my wife threatened to divorce me if we didn't sign Matt Thurman. She was like, you go get him now. Matt Thurman fits us. His personality fits us. He won a boatload of basketball games at Franklin High School. He can shoot it. He can pass it. He can think. He is a wonderful kid. So him making three threes in a row at the end of that game doesn't shock me. He, for a freshman, he doesn't have a conscience. He's like, just give me the ball and let me shoot it. But he can really pass it. And when given time and when given the opportunity, like Matt Thurman is going to be a really special player here at UAH. He fits our culture. He fits everything that we do here. And it's a lot of fun to watch him grow.
The way the schedule is setting up, I mean, two more road games. Wednesday looks like a big one. Looks like a big one, Coach. But it just feels like schedule-wise, it's lining up pretty good.
Well, I like where we are. The schedule flipped for us, and we had five at home in February and two on the road. But it's not scoreboard watching. It's our scoreboard watching. It's not watching other people. And you better take care of your own business. And we were really good last year at taking care of our own business. We were really good last year at redemption games. We don't like losing. We're not used to it. We don't like losing. And so when we do lose a game, we don't think this game hadn't been circled for many, many, many weeks, because it has. But 2 months ago, we got embarrassed and we got annihilated. And it was a lonely Sunday afternoon drive back up from Jackson, Mississippi. And we've been waiting on this game. But that doesn't mean that you're going to win it. It means that we're ready to play. I know that. They're a really good basketball team. I think they're a hard matchup for us, just to be honest. I think they're a tough matchup, so we're going to have to bring our A game. We got to get some back cuts. We got to get some good stuff going, and then we'll worry about Wednesday. And then after Wednesday, then we'll worry about that next Thursday and Saturday. But I like what listen, you give me a choice to play at MC or a choice to play at Spragans, or I'm playing here 101 times out of 100 playing right here at Spragans. So we've been good. We were – I like our mentality. I like our mode. I like, you know, when you get to February, it can't be this every game's intense. Oh, my gosh, it's do or die. You better have fun. And you better be pretty relaxed, and you better be in kind of the flow of things. And that's where we are right now. We understand what a big game this is. But we're also, this is February. This is the time where we got to get rolling. And this is the time, and we've won three in a row. And Saturday afternoon, Spraggins Hall, 4 o'clock, MC. We're juiced about this opportunity today.
I wanted to close with Chaney. He actually passed Brandon Roberts. And Brandon was a transfer from Samford and ended up with a little over 1,000 points. So he did it in 2 years as my point coach. And like Chaney, tell me a little bit about the growth of Chaney and what you've seen.
Well, the funniest thing is we get in the locker room the other day and Max looks at him and says, "Hey, man, welcome to the club." You know, we did it in about the same number of games. Max did it, and it took 8 years for Max to do it, averaging 3 points a game, and it took Chaney two. Listen, Chaney walks in here as a cult. I mean, he was a cult of a player. He was a horse, but he was a cult. And still remember, you know, his first game at LMU, and then we go to we get pounded, and we go to Union, and he's out there making plays and shooting shots like, "Chaney, you're a freshman. Just, you're not supposed to be even thinking about doing that." But the growth that he's had, and very simple, he's earned it. He's worked. He's in the gym all the time. His body has changed. His game has changed. And he's an amazing kid. He's a sweet kid. He's an amazing kid. He's got a wonderful family who's very supportive. He loves his roommates. He loves this team. He loves being at UAH. And his growth's been spectacular, you know. And, you know, we don't, you know, when he goes for 28, and we don't thank him enough, and we expect him to go for 28. So, you know, when he came into a little slump this year, you know, like anything else, he's a little kid. And you know, we've had some hard talks this year, and he has come out smiling, and he's really an unselfish kid and wants to help us win basketball games. And to do that, he needs to score another 1,000. It's a good start today. Let's see if he can put up in somewhere in the 20s. I don't think they'll double us a whole lot. They're big, they're athletic, and we don't have CJ down there. And so he's going to have to be a guy who can score that ball in the post for us today. And but I don't know if it's us scoring or, you know, 54, 55, 50, 92. You know, what doesn't fit there, the 92, and that's how many points we gave them down in Jackson or Clinton, Mississippi. So that's got to change. And once again, Chaney can help us on that end also.
Best of luck today.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
That is my conversation with head coach John Shulman. So he went with 28 for Chaney. He's more than halfway there, as he has 18 in the first half. That leads all scorers. Mississippi College had two players in double figures, Galen Smith with 13 and Tre'Davious Thompson with 10 in the first half. Chargers lead it 41-31 here at halftime. Chargers shot 50% from the floor. We were 15 of 30 from the floor, including 6 made threes, 5 of 6 at the free throw line. We were out-rebounded by a pretty big total, 23-15. The offensive glass was 11-4 in favor of MC as well. We'll see whether or not we can clean that up for the second half, as the Chargers lead it by 10, trying to stamp our ticket into the Gulf South Conference basketball tournament. Two teams have done so, with West Alabama and West Georgia already clinching spots into the Gulf South Conference tournament. What was said in the locker room there, Scott?
Yeah, a bunch of things addressed there at the halftime. You got to build the wall defensively. Got to continue to be tough defensively. What's happening is Mississippi College is driving in, kind of catching UAH kind of out of position a little bit. Coach Shulman going over some different things there. They've got to box out Galen Smith. He was a big topic of conversation at the halftime, Steve. And
yeah.
He has 5 of their 11 offensive rebounds. So Coach Shulman going over everything. If UAH is going to be successful, and Coach Shulman talked about this in the locker room, UAH defensively, Chaney Johnson, Daniel Saylor, Matt Thurman, whoever is guarding him, they've got to find a way to front Galen Smith. If Galen Smith gets the ball and the UAH is defending him from behind, then it's too late. Galen Smith will pick him apart. They've got to find a way to get out in front of him, outwork him down there in that paint.
We are trapping out of the gate. First possession belongs to the Choctaws. Thompson is fouled in the corner by Dane Harding just 8 seconds into the second half. Choctaws to plug it in. Into the far corner it goes. Thompson dribbles it out on the wing. Miller's turn with it. Miller wanting for Galen Smith to set a pick. He does so. Down underneath, Galen uses that chicken wing and then threw it away to Luke Burnett.
Laura, I mean, he had it around
his neck.
Jack Costell's neck.
Yeah. He really did. Max directing traffic, a chance to grow what is a 10-point lead. Max Shulman drives it into the paint. He'll float it, miss it, stick it back up and in. So he gets a rebound and a made bucket on that possession. He now has 11 in the game. Lead grows to 12. Miller dribbles it out and sends it into the far corner. Reed to Miller, resets it. Thompson hands it over. 10 on the shot clock. A long possession here. Walking with it was McCrary. No call. And then it's blocked away by Max Shulman. I said blocked by Max Shulman. Yeah. Wow. Luke Burnett to Max. Fires up the three. No good. Off the front of the rim. Boy, he wanted that. Lob it underneath to Smith. Smith loses the handle, but a foul. I think on the wrist by Dane Harding.
Look, Galen Smith has pretty much had his way down there in the paint, and then we get a little slap, and that's what we're going to get called.
Max Shulman blocks. That was his 4th block of the year. I knew there hadn't been many of them. Lob it underneath, down along the baseline. Smith sends it in the corner to Thompson. Rebound on the offensive glass and a foul on Max Shulman. That is already team foul number 3 for the Chargers. First foul for Max.
Yeah, but Steve, an interesting note here. Galen Smith actually out of the game now.
Yeah.
Less than 2 minutes into the half. UAH felt like they kind of winded him out a little bit in the first.
Lay-in rolls in for McCrary. Nobody stopped the ball right there. That was an easy possession. Costell dribbles it out at midcourt. The lead is 10 for the Chargers. Harding finds Chaney. Chaney backs his way into the paint, spins it, and it's ripped away. But a little too much of the body that time for Anthony Ratliff Jr.
Yeah, see, this kind of reminds me of a early 90s NBA game where you get that ball down in the paint and neither team is going to let you have a shot to get it in there. I mean, they're going to follow you hard to make sure that ball does not go into the basket. And that's a great example of it right there. Chaney Johnson had that easy spin move into the rim and just a good hard foul.
The old enforcer days.
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of what we're... I mean, Coach Shulman wants them to be kind of like that today.
Both free throws are good. Choctaws break the backcourt press. Thompson baseline jumper, no good. Rebounded by Chaney Johnson. There we go. Let's keep rebounding the basketball, please. The lead is 12. Jack Costell finds Dane Harding. Back to Jack. He'll drive it into the paint through some traffic. Kicks it outside to Luke Burnett. A wide open three is no good for Luke Burnett. Running it up, McCrary. finds Thompson. Thompson sends it in the corner to Miller. Miller dribbles it out with 17 on the shot clock. Thompson drives it. Jump stop floater is good. 12 in the game now for Tre'Davious Thompson. Lead shrinks to 10. 3 minutes gone into this second half. 45-35 Chargers. Costell starts off on the dribble on the left hand, drives it along the baseline, in the paint, lays it up. No, but fouled on his way up by McCrary. Into the free throw line goes the Chargers. UAH was 7 of 8 at the free throw line, or excuse me, 5 of 6 at the free throw line in the first half. So far, we're 2 of 2 here in this second half. Jack looking for his first point. That rims out, no good. Don't forget, we're back here on Wednesday taking on West Georgia. Second free throw is good. Full court press again for the Chargers. McCrary to Miller, drives it up along the far sideline. Miller dribbles it out at midcourt. Thompson goes around the arc, hands it over to McCrary. McCrary into the paint, bounces it off the shoe, it looked like, of Smith. And a turnover to UAH. Lob it ahead, and Dane Harding will lay it up and in. So, Dane, you're telling me you can't dunk the basketball? Is that what you're telling me? He can't dunk it.
Well, he just took the safe route.
I know.
Completely
messing with number 23. Like I can do that. Lob it underneath. Franklin.
What, lay it in or dunk it?
No, I can lay it up.
Okay.
The floater is up and good. But no, the next time I dunk a basketball will be the first time. 30-second timeout is called by Mississippi College, and it'll turn into our media timeout. 4 minutes gone here into the second half. Chargers leading at 48-37.
Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance, located in the Rosie's Shopping Plaza, strives to help customers find the best auto insurance, home insurance, life insurance, and more. No matter where you are in life, Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance is here to help you find your best insurance and retirement needs. You can find them on the web at brianbellamyagency.com or call them at 256-539-7530. Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance is a proud supporter of UAH Athletics and reminds everyone to go Chargers. Brian Bellamy State Farm, here to help life go right.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I have personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by other lawyers.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Other scores around the Gulf South Conference at halftime. It's Lee leading it at Auburn Montgomery, 41-40. Just a one-point lead. West Alabama having no problem with Delta State, 46-23. How about this for a final score? CBU beats West Florida, 67-66.
Wow, that's a big score. Now we've got another timeout, I guess.
A media timeout? No. You.
Well, the referee is saying media go. Everyone's looking around at him like, what?
All right. Start the clock. So we'll start it with him. And be right back.
Qualys Corporation, headquartered here in Huntsville, is a woman-owned small business providing technical services in the areas of engineering analysis, testing, and support services to both commercial and government customers. For 29 years, Qualys employees have provided award-winning support to complex technical and engineering efforts, helping ensure critical programs, products, and systems are acquired, tested, and fully operational when fielded. Qualys Corporation, proud sponsor of the UAH Chargers. Go Chargers!
Tom Luganbill here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience the tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch. at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there, Woody Anderson Ford.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
48-37, Chargers maintain the lead here at home. A lead that has been as much as 13. No changes for the Chargers as the starters stay out there. We'll plug it in at midcourt with 23 on the shot clock. 15:52 left to go in the game.
Well, Steve, those back-to-back media timeouts really do have to favor Mississippi College. Coach Showman in the one before that was talking about that, you know, hey, well, we're close to doing this one because they're a little winded.
Yeah.
And now they've gotten two-minute breaks there.
Luke Burnett on the wing finds Dane Harding. The back door is shut off. Now Chaney opens the door himself, lays it up. No, stick back. No good as well, and rebounded by Mississippi College. Just kicked that door down, 31. Thompson drives it, holds it, and sends it back outside to Miller. Thompson drives it into the free throw line. Back to Miller for three. No good. Chaney pulls the board. 5 minutes gone into the second half. Chaney holds it, lobs it to Dane out beyond the arc. Chaney gets a high pick from 23. Dane ends up with it and hands it over to Max Schulman. Max, it gets deflected out to midcourt, 7 on the shot clock. Kostel, 4 on the shot clock. Jack Kostel spins it, floats it just inside the arc. No good. Rebounded by Mississippi College.
Yeah, a couple missed opportunities there offensively for UAH.
McCrary is fouled, and one opportunity for McCrary as Dane Harding was a tad late there defensively. That's his third foul. Here comes Saylor and Hunter. There goes Harding and Kostel. So McCrary, the and one, no good, and rebounded by UAH. Hunter Vick to bring it up along the far sideline. Bounces it to Luke Burnett. Boy, the defense is pushing us well beyond the arc. Saylor has his left foot on the logo. Underneath it goes to Chaney. Powers his way up, and he is fouled underneath. I think that's on Ratliff. It is, and that's his third.
Well, great entry pass there to Chaney Johnson. Chaney made the beautiful spin move, Steve, to put himself within 3 or 4 feet, but then a triple team showed up.
Yeah. Inbounds it goes to Chaney. Nice feed by Max. Lob it in for Chaney Johnson. He now has 22 in the game. Lead grows to 11 at 50-39. 6 minutes gone into this second half. Miller to Thompson. Thompson has it on the wing. Starts off the dribble. Reset it to McCrary. Uses that left foot as the pivot, and he'll drive it in. Kick it in the corner. Open three. Thompson. Good. Third made three for Thompson. I think we are all well aware of what he is capable of to do.
We are, and Steve, without Galen Smith on the floor, this is Thompson's game now. Yep. And UAH is going to have to get a hand out there. They've got to get to the tape.
8-point lead. We'll try to grow it, and three ball's no good for Max. Here come the Choctaws. Miller brings it up. Miller looking for Thompson. Thompson ends up with it. Thompson drives it into the elbow, kicks it outside. McCrary walks with it, no call. Little floater, it actually bounced past underneath, and the layup rolls in for Franklin. Well executed that time by Mississippi College. Hunter Vick out at midcourt. The lead is 6 as Saylor. How is that on Saylor? No, it's not. Okay, I thought they were going to call on it on Saylor, but Thompson guilty of the reach. Both the Choctaws and Chargers with 4 team fouls apiece with 12:47 to go in this second half. Max Schulman to plug it into play. They do so in the backcourt. Hunter Vick will retrieve it. Vick brings it up. Hunter Vick bounces it to Max Schulman. Move it around the arc. Again, they're pushing us well outside of the arc.
Yeah, they're pushing us out there. See, we can't get anything going.
Vick, his attempted shot ends up deflected out of bounds to UAH.
I mean, you're talking about 18, 20, 22 feet outside before. I mean, trying to start our offense with 10 seconds out there is not ideal.
No. 12:26 on the clock. Galen Smith went to the desk, and then Coach Bolden said, sit down. That's interesting. Running it up is Miller. He goes coast to coast and lays it up and in. I mean, Smith went to the scorer's table, and Bolden said, no. Timeout, UIH. This is a four-point game all of a sudden. At 50-46, we'll take a timeout as well.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Four locations and on the web at sportsmedalabama.com.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Chargers plug it into play into the backcourt, and Hunter Vick will bring it up.
Well, see, there was a lot of confusion between the referees and the scores table there with this last timeout. The scores table announced it as a media. The referee said 30.
Yeah.
Neither coach knew exactly what was going on.
Daniel Saylor is held underneath by Franklin. And this is the media timeout. So we got timeouts all over the place. 11:55 to go. It's the Chargers with a four-point lead here at home over the Choctaws from Mississippi College.
Qualis Corporation, headquartered here in Huntsville, is a woman-owned small business providing technical services in the areas of engineering analysis, testing, and support services to both commercial and government customers. For 29 years, Qualis employees have provided award-winning support to complex technical and engineering efforts, helping ensure critical programs, products, and systems are acquired, tested, and fully operational when fielded. Qualis Corporation, proud sponsor of the UAH Chargers. Go Chargers!
Tom Luganbill here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience the tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there, Woody Anderson Ford.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Tanner Schulman, Max Schulman, Daniel Saylor, Jack Costell, and Chaney Johnson, the five on the floor for UAH.
Well, Coach Schulman reminding everyone of that timeout. You got a guard, and Bree McCrary hurting UAH right now simply by just driving to the basket.
Yeah.
Coach said, we got to seal off the lane. We've got to do something to stop him from just getting into the lane.
That is Ratliff's fourth foul of the game. He held Daniel Saylor, and coach is not looking to Galen Smith at all. Interesting. Costell gets double teamed on the corner, gets out of it. Tanner Schulman's wide open, finds Max, 10 on the shot clock. Daniel Saylor hands it over to Jack for three. No good. Rebounded by Max. Tanner for three. No good. Rebounded by Mississippi College. Miller runs it up. Miller attacks it. hands it over, and it's out of bounds. Last touch by Max Schulman.
Well, Steve, you can argue. I mean, as good as Galen Smith has been for Mississippi College, the Choctaws have gotten closer with a smaller lineup. They've
been true.
A little bit more
apt
to run a little bit, getting into the rim a little bit easier with this smaller lineup.
So Galen Smith is back into the game. Charger lead is 4. Thompson sends it in the corner. He'll get it right back. Swings it to Miller. 10 on the shot clock. Miller. 8 on the shot clock. Bounce it to Thompson for 3. No good. Rebounded by UAH. Nice box out by Cheney.
Yeah, he pushed Galen Smith underneath the rim, Steve. Big man don't like that. They don't like to be caught underneath the rim like that.
Costell drives it into the free throw line. Hands it over to Dane Harding. Now Cheney dribbles it out. 10 on the shot clock for the Chargers. Cheney to Harding. Dane with 7 on the shot clock. Attacks the baseline, gets shoved. I'm sorry, if that's a foul, then there needs to be about 80 more of those.
Yeah, I don't know what contact is today.
I really don't.
Freedom. Because we've seen a lot of contact.
Yes. So it is free throw time here for the Chargers. This is a 1-1 opportunity for Dane Harding. First free throw of the day. Front end is good. Dane will get one more. Dane Harding on the year 17 of 18 coming into the game from the free throw line. Second free throw rolls in for Harding as well. Lead grows to 52-46. Dribbling it out is Miller. Handed over to Thompson. It's a high pick there from Smith. Smith getting covered up by Max Schulman defensively. Thompson dribbles it out on the right hand. A long 2, banked it in for Thompson. Okay, we had one of those 2. Those kind of cancel each other out, I guess.
Well, we're still +1 in the bank department. Ours was a 3.
That's true. 52-48, Chargers lead it with 10 minutes to go. Dodd to Costell. 12 on the shot clock. Back door is there, and Max lays it up and in. Actually, excuse me, Jack Costell. I'm so used to Max doing that.
Well, yeah, Costell, I mean,
off the
put
pump
on the brakes. I mean,
yeah.
what pump fake, too?
That's a top gun of just slam on the brakes and let them fly by. A long 2, no good for Thompson. Rebounded by Dane Harding. How is that a double dribble? I would love an explanation on how that was a double dribble.
And Jack's trying to get an explanation.
So the old rule was you couldn't dribble the ball with 2 hands. That's no longer the rule.
I don't know what Jack did.
I don't know either. Lob it underneath, and Galen Smith gets a free bucket, courtesy of the officials. The lead is 4 at 54-50. Harding, top of the key. Steps back out beyond the arc. Lob it underneath to Dodd. Dodd, back to the bucket, backs his way into the paint. Dodd kicks it out. 3 ball. Harding, no good. Long rebound goes to the Choctaws. Only a 4-point lead here for UAH. Miller directing some traffic. Stolen away by Jack Costell. Here's a 2-on-2. Jack attacks it. Hands it over to the trailer. Tanner Schulman. No good off of that bank. Rebounded by Max, and he'll lay it up and in. Lead grows to 6.
Yeah, Max missed the first run, but just so happened to be right in his way.
Crowd making some noise here at Spraggins as the floater for Miller is up and good. Lead shrinks to 4 again at 56-52. 8 minutes and 11 seconds to go. Harding holds it, starts off the dribble. Sends it outside further to Max Schulman. Kostel with it in the near corner. Seven on the shot clock. Kostel attacks the baseline, spins it, floats it, scores it. Jack Kostel with five here in this second half. It's 58-52 Chargers. Miller dribbles it out at midcourt. This game is way too close. Into the corner, step back three. No good that time. Stick back opportunity is no good for Reed, but he was fouled by Max Schulman. Timeout on the floor, 7 minutes and 30 seconds to play. Chargers lead it over the Choctaws, 58-52.
Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance, located in the Rosie's Shopping Plaza, strives to help customers find the best auto insurance, home insurance, life insurance, and more. No matter where you are in life, Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance is here to help you find your best insurance and retirement needs. You can find them on the web at brianbellamyagency.com or call them at 256-539-7530. Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance is a proud supporter of UAH Athletics and reminds everyone to go Chargers. Brian Bellamy State Farm, here to help life go right.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I have personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by other lawyers.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Mississippi College is shooting 58% from the floor here in this second half. They are 10 of 17, including 1 of 5 from beyond the arc, and they have outscored us here in this second half, 21-17.
Well, Steve, a lot of that is coming within 5 feet of the rim. That's why Coach Schulman's been preaching, you've got to build that wall, you've got to keep them out of the lane. Mississippi College, and especially B. McCrary, has gotten easy looks at the rim just by getting downhill.
Front end is good for Reed. He'll get one more. Incidentally, that foul on Max Schulman was his second foul. Fifth team foul. Second free throw for Reed. Rims out, no good. Chargers.
Max is also dealing with a little bit of cramping issue, trying to gave him some salt tablets during that timeout, Steve, just to try to kind of buy him some time.
Into the paint goes our point guard. Floater off the glass is good. Jack Kostel with the moves down low. Lead grows to 7 at 60-53. 7 minutes to go in what is a 7-point lead. Thompson swings it to Reed. Miller with it, looking for Smith down low. Smith, though, covered up by Dalton Dodd. Thompson swings it. McCrary drives it, loses his balance. How is that? He lost his balance. He lost his balance. This is Auburn all over again. Just lose your balance next to a player and they'll call it on us. That foul is on Luke Burnett. Unreal. Inbounds it goes to Smith. The layup no good. Pops around, then the floater is no good. Ends up out of bounds off of Daniel Saylor. Saylor does have three fouls, but he can be a little more physical here down the stretch.
I mean, see, that was 2-on-1. That was Galen Smith, Daniel Saylor, and Chaney Johnson all down low.
Smith kicks it out. Somehow he didn't walk with it. Corner three, Miller, no good. Rebounded by Galen Smith. Another three, another walk, not called. And a missed dunk that time by Ratliff. Ball don't lie. 7-point lead, 60-53. Max Schulman. A foul underneath on Thompson. That's his third foul. Into the free throw line goes Chaney. Chaney in this one is 5 of 6 at the free throw line.
At the free throw line, Chaney Johnson, number 31.
Front end, Chaney at 18 in the first half. And so far, just 4 here in the second half as the front end of the 1-1 is no good. It's basically a turnover. 6:03 on the second half clock as Miller dribbles it out. Miller swings it. Into the corner it goes to Thompson. Thompson back to Miller, 10 on the shot clock. McCrary drives it, spins it, walks with it, and hands it over, and that's a should be a foul on Chaney. If they're going to call goaltending, which I think is the right call, they're going to look at it. You cannot grab the rim. You cannot do that.
Yeah, you can't, but I don't know. Was the ball actually in flight towards the rim at the time?
You know, you've got a solid point there. I don't think it left his hand.
I think Chaney, no, there's no doubt he grabbed the rim.
Oh, yeah.
We all saw that. I just don't know if the ball was actually in flight.
They are counting a hoop. They're calling it goaltending for grabbing the rim. Can you not look at it? Can we not look at this? Why can't we look at this?
Wait, wait.
So Galen Smith will get an and one. And the free throw is good. So it's a 4-point game at 60-56. Running it up, Jack Kostel dribbles it out at midcourt. Jack will drive it hard along the baseline, lays it up, no. Rebounded by Miller. Good backside help by Galen Smith. Underneath lay-in, rolls in for Miller, his third made field goal of this second half. It's a 2-point game.
Well,
60-58.
A ragtag style of game, Steve. It's very physical. I mean, again, I think Mississippi Collins dictating the tempo.
Yep. Sailor threw it away, but a hold underneath will send Chaney Johnson to the free throw line. Yeah, this is definitely MC's type of game.
Yeah, I mean, they're able, but still, though, UAH needs to be able to stop Mississippi Collins from getting into the lane.
Front end. No good. That's two front ends of 1-1s that we've missed. Basically a turnover again.
Yeah.
A chance for the Choctaws, who have been down by as much as 13, to tie this game. Miller bounces at McCrary. Walks his way in and lays it up and in. And I mean walks his way in.
Well, he's using that right elbow. He's taking that right elbow and putting it in to the gut of our defender. And basically, he's like a fullback. He's putting his head down, Steve, and just running through the lane.
We're tied at 60 with 4.5 minutes to play. And you can see the pep in the step defensively for the Choctaws. Sailor, top of the key. Daniel Sailor swings it to Luke Burnett for three. He's fouled, and he'll head to the free throw line. Thompson commits his fourth foul, and Luke Burnett has not scored here in this second half. I wonder why they did not go to at least look at the monitor. It's up to their discretion.
Yeah, and I don't know, maybe that was not a reviewable play at the time. I know when it's under 4 minutes, I believe the referees can use any kind of discretion. We'll see if we can get a word or a clarification on that during the next media timeout.
Two free throws are made for Luke Burnett. It's a 2-point Charger lead. One more to go. That rolls in for Luke. Trey Bates checks in. Checks in for, I thought they were about to check out Thompson. McCrary checks out. 63-60, Chargers with a 3-point lead as down the stretch we go here at home. Miller bounces it out. Miller swings it to Thompson, and a foul underneath on... That is on Smith, throwing down Max Schulman. And for Smith, that is his first foul of the game, believe it or not.
I mean, that's...
That's laughable.
It is.
Because of how physical he has been playing in this one. Full court press for the Choctaws. The lead is only three. Mississippi College has tied this when it was at 60, but they have not led in this game. Dane Harding to bring it up. Dane dribbles it out at midcourt. Dane Harding maintains the dribble. Now drives it, bounces it underneath to Max Schulman. Max backs his way into the paint. Kick it outside, underneath to Max, turns, shoots, and misses. Here come the Choctaws with 3:37 on the clock. McCrary loses the handle, regains it, hands it over to Miller. Miller bounces it to Thompson for three, and it's an air ball taken out by UIH. Would love any kind of points on this possession. Harding hands it over. Costell with 12 on the shot clock finds Luke Burnett. We have not scored in over 4 minutes of game time. A field goal. Swing it over. Harding at the buzzers. No good, but rebounded by Luke Burnett. Chance to kill more clock. A lead of only three. Costell rolls it up ahead to Chaney. Work it out, big man. He'll float it and miss it, but he is fouled by Reed. Free throw time for Chaney Johnson. He's 0 for his last two. We will be back here after our final media timeout.
Qualis Corporation, headquartered here in Huntsville, is a woman-owned small business providing technical services in the areas of engineering analysis, testing, and support services to both commercial and government customers. For 29 years, Qualis employees have provided award-winning support to complex technical and engineering efforts, helping ensure critical programs, products, and systems are acquired, tested, and fully operational when fielded. Qualis Corporation, proud sponsor of the UAH Chargers. Go Chargers!
Tom Luganbill here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience the tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there. Woody Anderson for
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Like to welcome those of you listening over the airwaves of 97.7 ESPN The Zone. We are inside Spraggins on a Saturday as down the stretch we go. It's been a full day. The women won earlier today in 2 minutes, 41 seconds is on the clock, and the Chargers, who have led it by as much as 13, lead it by three. 63-60 over Mississippi College.
Well, Steve, I did get a clarification as to why the referees did not review that goaltending call there. And under 2 minutes is when they can actually review that, a goaltending call. So there was no way that the referees could even review it because it does not fall underneath the protocol to review.
Both free throws are good for Chaney. Lead grows to 5, 65-60. 2 minutes and 35 seconds to play in this one. Miller swings it. Now Thompson ends up with it. Miller drives it in, kick it out to Thompson underneath to Smith, and he'll lay it up and in. Timeout taken by Mississippi College. Charger women won earlier 74-49. Here, the Chargers right out of the gate took a 9-2 advantage, and you thought this may be a 30-point romp in our favor considering what happened in Mississippi, but the Choctaws punched us right back. And what was a 10-point lead for the Chargers at halftime at 41-31.
Yeah.
And they've crept back even closer here in this second half, outscoring this 29-24.
Well, Steve, if you look at it closely now, I can kind of understand why Mississippi College, you kind of understand what they were doing with Galen Smith.
Yeah.
He was winded. And if they would have played him extensively there in that second half, they've had him on the floor for majority here of the second half, but now they're going with that smaller lineup, that lineup that has been given UAH fits.
Yeah. An inbounds attempt is blocked out of bounds by McCrary. Now Cheney cannot move. Inbounds it goes. Costa will bring it up. A three-point Charger lead at 65-62. 2:13 to play. Jack looking for Cheney. Cheney wants that basketball, but he's well defended by Ratliff. Bounce it underneath to Cheney. Cheney backs his way in, powers his way up, and he is mauled pretty good by Ratliff. That'll be it for Ratliff. He is fouled out of the game. Two free throws coming up here for the Chargers. Our last made field goal was a Jack Costell layup at 7:16 on the clock. There's a minute and 59 right now. So to say we've had a drought is an understatement.
Yeah, I mean, we're going to have to win this line from the free throw stripe, and there's no doubt about that. But you look at the Choctaws, Steve, they do have some foul trouble on the board right now. Tre'Davious Thompson has four fouls, and he's still out on the floor right now.
And Galen Smith has four as well. Cheney makes both free throws. It's 67-62. Dribbling it out. Miller hands it over to Bates. Kick it into the corner. Thompson ends up with it. Back outside it goes. That's to Bates. 10 on the shot clock. Miller drives it in. Kick it into the corner. Three ball contested. No good. Rebounded by Cheney. 67-62. Chargers hanging on for dear life against Mississippi College. Dane Harding holds it on the Charger logo. Hand it over to Jack Costell. 12 on the shot clock. He draws a double team. Somebody's open. Cheney loses the handle and it rolls out of bounds. Turnover number four, believe it or not, for UAH.
Well, Cheney kind of hung his head there just a little bit. He's got to have a short memory.
Yes.
Because, I mean, we all know, I mean, down by five, Mississippi College can shoot that three in a hurry or go down low.
Minute 12 left to go. Timeout is called. Earlier today, it was Alabama, a winner over LSU, 79-69, as you heard over the airwaves right here on 97.7 ESPN The Zone. Some other scores from around the GSE. It was Christian Brothers, one better than West Florida in a little bit of an upset, 67-66. West Alabama had zero problem with Delta State. Still 2 minutes left to go in that one at Pruitt Hall, 68-39. In the second half, it's Lee leading it at Auburn Montgomery, 70-65. It'll be Choctaw basketball as they'll plug it in their own backcourt, and Miller will walk it up. Thompson holds it out at midcourt. By all means, take your time. Miller to Thompson, drives it, hard baseline, kicks it back outside. Miller to Thompson, fires it in the corner. A contested threes, no good. Rebounded by UAH.
See, there's bodies falling all over every time that ball goes into the rim.
Costell brings it up across the timeline. 41, 40, 39 seconds as, oh, you're going to foul Luke Burnett? I'm fine with that. I'm not sure that'll be Coach Bolden's first choice, but that is the second foul for McCrary. And Luke Burnett back to the free throw line. We still have not made a field goal in nearly 7 minutes. For Front end is good. Thank goodness for free throws. We're 13 of 16 from the free throw line this half.
Well, and thank goodness for UAH, Steve, attacking the rim.
Yeah.
Not settling for threes and enforcing the issue of getting to the rim.
Driving it is Miller. Layup no good. And fouled on his way up off the stick back was Galen Smith. Galen Smith is 5 of 6 at the free throw line in this game. Just the fifth attempt this half for Mississippi College. Front end is good. Smith will get one more. 2-possession game right now. Second free throw is up and good. Chargers to plug it into play, leading at 69-64. A lot can happen in 29 seconds. And fouled in the backcourt is Jack Kostel. And we will walk to the other end. It's double bonus time here for the Chargers. Crary guilty of his third foul. Coach Bolden was wondering where the foul was, and that was more of a wrestling takedown than anything. You want to know where the foul is? Really? Front end is good. This is the biggie right here. No good. It's still a 2-possession game. Thompson on the wing. Fires up the contested three. No good. Rebounded by Chaney. And Chaney is fouled in the backcourt. And that may do it. How do you win a game without scoring a bucket for over 7 minutes? You make free throws. So at this rate, our last made field goal will be at 7:16. Front end is no good for Chaney. This is still a 2-possession game. We need one of these, 31. Second free throw is good. Now I feel better. Running it up is Miller. Miller, top of the key. Skips it in the corner. They're not going to call a walk. Three is no good. Stick back rolls in for McCrary. Timeout taken by Mississippi College. It's a 5-point lead with 6.9 to play. And again, for those of you listening over the airways of 97.7 ESPN The Zone, coming up at 7 o'clock, you'll have Huntsville Havoc Hockey over the airwaves, as Austin Coletti will be on the play-by-play call tonight as the Birmingham Bulls are in town tonight. We are back here inside Spraggan's Wednesday night, and that is set up to be a rather important game. If we can hang on here, as we're a game behind West Georgia, we've already beaten West Georgia at West Georgia, so we could potentially own a tiebreaker with the Wolves. As the Choctaws are already out onto the court. No doubt that Choctaws are going to try to steal a possession here if they can. Jack Kostel to plug it into play. Why are we plugging it in along the baseline? I thought the timeout was taken in the backcourt.
It was a made basket.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, it was a made basket coming off Mississippi College. So UAH has the ability to run the baseline.
Costell heaves the home run pass and ahead to Chaney. Chaney loses the handle and it's stolen away. 3 seconds. Lob it forward to Miller at the buzzer. No good. Chargers hang on. And down Mississippi College, 71-66. Chargers did not have a made field goal in the final 7 minutes and 16 seconds of play.